I'm Shelby Bauer, and welcome to the Sugar Scoop. So today we're going to be making a class ring cake. I'm super excited about this cake because I've been doing class rings a ton. I've made so many of them, and I kind of started off my career making lots of class rings. So I'm finally putting it into a video. Now this is not a step-by-step tutorial, it's pretty much just me making the cake, but I wanted you guys to be able to see what goes into making a class ring cake. I will tell you guys kind of my process real quick before the video starts. I pretty much just find out whatever class ring I'm making, so this one is an Aggie ring cake, obviously, which is really popular out here. I'm from Houston. Class ring cakes make great grooms cakes because they do have like a really nice round shape, so you do get plenty of cake in there even though it is a sculpted cake. I do not cut the centers out completely. I go in a little bit to give it the illusion that it's cut out, but then I leave a little black circle on the base and leave probably about 4 inches of cake in there, so you're still getting plenty of cake. We're starting out with an Aggie ring cake, so I'm going to go online and I'm going to find pictures of like the face of the ring and the sides of the rings, and then I'm going to print them out, make little templates out of paper, and then I pretty much just wing it from there. So just make sure you have your reference out, you're constantly checking your reference going back and forth, and you guys will do a good job too. I am using Madame Loulou chocolate fondant this for the whole ring. Now the reason why I do the chocolate fondant underneath is to give it kind of like an oxidized look, so that when I paint it with gold on the outside it pops a little bit more. I know a lot of you guys are going to be wanting to know what gold I used on this cake. This is actually a mixture that I'm working on. I'm not 100% happy with it, so I'm not ready to share it yet. You can do this whole process with modeling chocolate too, so feel free to make your own modeling chocolate. So let's get started. I'm covering my board in Madame Loulou's maroon fondant, rolling it out thin, then wetting my board with water, and then getting all the air bubbles out. I'm using a smaller cake circle than my cake because I will carve it down later. I'm using a chocolate cake base with chocolate ganache and chocolate frosting. Thin layers of frosting to keep the cake nice and stable. I'm crumb coating the cake to keep it moist in the fridge so it's nice and cold for carving. I'm using the template that I made for the front of the ring. This is how big I want the oval in the center to be, and I'm seeing how much height I need to add to the face of the ring. I'm starting to carve the cake. Carving it in at the top and at the bottom, looking at my reference photos while I carve. To make the illusion of a hole in the ring, I'm using a cake circle as my template, cutting a shallow hole out of the top of the cake. Now that I'm happy with the shape of the ring, I'm going to cover the cake in a layer of chocolate ganache. I smooth out each coat of chocolate ganache as much as I can, then I stick it back in the fridge to chill. This makes it easier to add another layer of chocolate ganache, and I just keep adding layers and smoothing it out until I'm happy with the result. I like to use an acrylic scraper sometimes. I have a piece of, this is just stencil paper that I'm using. It's like a plastic, kind of thicker paper. It works really well. Anything that's flexible, plastic, and smooth will help you kind of get those curves anything you can kind of bend into a round shape is going to be really helpful for making a class ring. I decided the top needed a little more height, so I added some cake. Best to do it now before the fondant. I ran out of ganache, so I finished off the outside with a layer of chocolate frosting, got it really smooth, and then I let it chill before covering it with fondant. I'm using Madame Loulou chocolate fondant. It's a weird shape, so just take your time and be patient. It doesn't have to be perfect. There's a lot of decorations going on top. I always add a hammered texture on the inside to emphasize the metal look. It doesn't really matter if this is actually on the ring, it always looks good. I'm using a simple pattern that I made to cut out the oval for the face of the ring. I'm using water and a small paintbrush to break down the sugar in the fondant and make it sticky enough to glue the decorations to. The more details you add to each design, the better the whole ring will look in the end. I just keep checking my references, making sure I'm making everything the way it looks in the photo. Tiny star cutters are very helpful, but I have made the tiny stars by hand in the past just using my X-Acto blade. Now let's get started on the other side. Yep, this thing takes a lot of work. I prefer to hand paint the gold with a fluffy eyeshadow brush. This helps bring out the raised parts and keeps everything that's recessed nice and dark. I'm adding a little bit of edible gold glitter to just kind of make the face of it sparkle a little bit. And then I'm going to add my ribbon and we're done. How cool is this cake? It turned out so good. I hope you guys think the same. If you like this video, then make sure to like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, check me out on Instagram at Shelby Elizabeth Cakes, and you can see what I'm up to. And I hope you guys enjoyed everything, and thank you so much for watching.